20 minutes. November 23rd into the 24th, what do we know? Sherman Compatello arrives at the home for a welfare check. He told him he'd done them plenty of times. There were lots of people on the island. He'd never had one quite like this. He knew something wasn't right. Rich Doody's body was discovered in a green blanket in the beach house in the living room. And he learned that our crime scene investigative unit detectives processed that scene. They took photographs. They took a voluminous amount of evidence. The defense wanted and moved in the whole report that lists, I submit to you, over 300 pieces of evidence. A bloody label with what clearly at that time looked like print was taken to CSI. And interestingly, another entry on those Easy Pass records at the times of her toll, 309 at the Barnegat Light, 322 that Monday, November 23rd. You go back again. Try to finish the cleanup. That's the house where it started. Where for Mr. G, it ended. Chama Compatello told you. Cars were in the driveway. That was a problem. No one was answering the door. S5 in evidence, when he walked up to that door, he could see through the window a body wrapped in a green blanket. As the house was being processed, right, you can clearly see there's not. That fixture turned to the side, that bulb missing, why? Why would that matter? Where was that light, ladies and gentlemen? To the far right of the house, the only point of access to the upstairs. Anybody going in and out of that side door would have to walk right by that. Why would it be missing? Because you don't want to be seen? Because you're removing items of evidence from the home. The trash. The living room of 2204 Central Avenue, S21. What was in that trash? Among other things, the light bulb. And that silver can. Pieces of broken lamp, as you can see, covered in red steam. I submit to you, covered in blood. And you heard Sergeant Starkey testify that early on they were able to get a photograph of that paint print, and that the print was individualized to the left middle finger of this defendant. There were three other prints also individualized. Left and right middle, and two conference. He was there when blood was shed, when he cleaned up that crime scene. The state knew that from very early on in this investigation. Did they miss something? Of the 300 pieces or more of evidence, did they forget to collect something? I submit to you, no, ladies and gentlemen. They very quickly, through their investigation, were able to hone in on this defendant because that's what the evidence showed them. Why would they keep looking when they found the evidence? S23, the living room of 2204 Central Avenue. I show you this photo for a number of reasons. In the foreground, an intact lamp. What's missing from that glass table? The other lamp. I'd also note, and we'll talk more about it, self-defense. Oh, there's only one way out of this house? I'm sorry, ladies and gentlemen. S23, what do you see right there? If there's this altercation going here, is there not a space right between these two couches? And it can't be seen in this, but if you recall, and you'll have all the other He knew there was another door there. There's no other way. There's no other choice. Turn around and go out that sliding glass door. This coffee table. You've heard much about this coffee table. S-33. There's another knife there. Well, what else? There's a cop sitting upright. If this was such a fight for their lives, why is none of this shoved off the table? How's there still a cop sitting upright? Is there any blood that you see on this knife? There's also some fishing line here, some other mechanism. And I believe there was some conversation about how the table had been moved. How do we know that? How do we know that Mr. Doody didn't just keep it on an angle so when he was sitting over here, he could access all these things? I submit to you, ladies and gentlemen, this isn't evidence of a fight. It's just a table. And in fact, I think it more reasonably and circumstantially demonstrates there was no knockdown, drag-out fight in the area of this coffee table. Everything seems in its place, except we know that this blood came from the chair and the bludgeoning that happened just off screen here. How do we know that? S-36? Their beach house. This chair. John Garkowski told you. This spatter evidence. Rich Doody was sitting in that chair when he was beaten over the head. How many times did Dr. Hood tell you? How many injuries did he count? I submit to you, again, your recollection controls. He counted at least 10. Jan Johnson agreed. Yeah. The victim was sitting in this chair when the bloodshedding or bloodletting events occurred. She couldn't tell you if he was always sitting in the chair, but when I asked her, is it impossible the victim was seated in that chair the whole time? It was possible. That was her answer. The victim was sitting here and had been beaten over the head at least 10 times. Who was he threatening at that point? How was he a threat to anyone? As he sat in the chair, being hit on the left side of his head, and there were two areas of impact as his head moved further to the right as he was being beaten and died. He was coming after his friend. He was a threat to anyone? That's not conjecture, ladies and gentlemen. That's not speculation. The defense's own expert told you that same thing that John Garkowski, that the evidence shows you. That's 50. The fragment in the chair. It was stuck with blood. It was stuck to the chair. What's important in this? Those handprints, ladies and gentlemen. Okay. Let's talk about the evidence. Let's talk about what makes sense. So, the victim was sitting in this chair, being beaten about the head, and Dr. Hood testified, and Jan Johnson agreed, but there was chemo aspiration. He was still breathing when his throat was cut. She also said there was no bloodshed until the victim was in the chair. So if he's in the chair, hit about the head multiple times, his head going to the right, yet he somehow has the ability to turn and move his hand, or ladies and gentlemen, are those handprints, as John Garkowski said, more consistent with this defendant, who'd also cut himself at some point, leaning over the chair, as his friend was dead. Leaning over the chair and stabbing him. Leaning over the chair and slitting his throat. Which makes more sense? Someone who's been struck and is bleeding. And we know by that point he had to be in the chair. Even Jan
Jan Johnson told you that backpack that was in the chair during the event. How can you know that? How can she say that? But what do we have? That blue star, that luminol. She called this a smear. But we know that the victim was in the chair for 6 to 8 hours, and then the victim was dragged out of the chair and placed on the floor. Isn't this evidence more consistent with the victim being in the chair? And then when Mr. Sipa comes back the next day, he drags him out of the chair and places him on the floor. And then the backpack was put there at some point during the cleanup. How can we know? Does it matter? I think it's not a lot. But what is the evidence showing you? The golf club. S-46. Who said the golf club is what caused Mr. Doody's death? What are the elements of the charges? We'll go back over them. That it was used in this assault. That it was used to inflict injury, serious bodily injury. Dr. Hood told you he believed that caused death. Involved the knife. I submit to you, why would the head of this golf club be in a bucket? There's cleaner at the scene. What else was in that bucket? This wasn't a random head of a golf club. There's paper towels. The golf club was tucked in amongst those paper towels on top of bloody shards of ceramic. So just as a courtesy, this defendant during the cleanup picked up an unrelated broken golf club? Does that make sense? Or does the circumstantial evidence instead show you that he took some of these paper towels in S-77, shoved in the bucket, and he wiped down the golf club? Much was made of the question asked of Teresa Nezazon, if something was wiped down, would you expect to find DNA? Your recollection controls, but I submit to you, State didn't ask if you wiped down the knife. If you wiped down an object, would you expect to find DNA on it? If you wiped down the golf club, would you expect to find DNA on it? Well, the answer is no. Why would a state agency submit something that did not appear at all to have anything on it that was dusted for prints and came back with none? Surprising? It was wiped down, I submit to you. That's where the question was getting at. Not the knife. The golf club. It's to you to decide if the state's proven beyond a reasonable doubt the golf club had anything to do with this incident. There was no testimony, it was the cause of death. Hit Rich Doody with this golf club, I submit to you the circumstantial evidence suggests yes. Proof, yes. Why would it be in a bucket with paper towels covered in blood on top of ceramic fragments also covered in blood if it had nothing to do with it? What did have something to do with everything in this case? S-20, the knife. It's also an offense. S-95, the physical knife, you'll have it. Like to look at it. Whose blood is on this knife? Rich Doody's. Where was it found? In the kitchen sink. Where did it come from? Is there actually any evidence that Rich Doody ever held this knife? Let's talk about that in a minute. So November 25th, what do we know? The detectives went to One Homelands Drive in Cold Snack. By that time, they had their suspect. They had their bloody fingerprint. They had reviewed the traffic videos. They had the ALP they took. When they walked in the living room, there was a coffee table. There was a watch on the coffee table. Just for the sake of argument, is this coffee table flush to the chair? So, did we move it? Was it like that? What does matter? This watch, this men's watch. Covered with a red staining. You'll have that to look at too. Like? S-121. This red staining by the clasp, whose DNA was that? In the killing. S-112. The shower ring catch. It's weird. But it drew the detective's attention because there was a brand new package in a nice closet. And a brand new catch in the shower. And at the time, I submit to you, we all thought, weird, why is that there? Because this defendant went home. He got there. Sometime after midnight, 12:35, he went north on the earth. He went home, and I submit to you. Yes, it makes sense. Maybe he took a shower. Didn't want anybody to know. There's red staining on that drain catch. It was found in the garbage in the bathroom. An attempt to cover up what he had done, where he had been. It was something that drew their attention. Was out of place. What else drew the attention of detectives when they searched the clothes neck home, this defendant's home? In the garage, tucked in the corner, are a number of items that looked like trash. But through those items drew their attention. The blue moon, purchased on the 21st. Some magnets. Broken bolt. As you entered the garage on the left, a shelf with a box of Blue Moon beer. The Jeep itself. The license plate. It was processed, it was taken into evidence. You heard about the stain in the back of that Jeep the state didn't tell you about. Why not? Why wasn't that significant to the state's case? We knew. The defendant had a cause. Nobody hid that from you. That evidence was offered to you. Is it surprising that there be, I submit to you, a small swipe of blood in the backseat of the defendant's vehicle? No. But how did that advance the state's case? What did that have to do with anything? There's no hiding anything from you. We can get a cause, Mickey. So sure, his blood is in the back. That box, the picture S-123. Remember the dates, the numbers that the detectives talked about? MAR-2816 and the C-300 number? Where do you see those numbers? Well, in the bottles in the box, not surprising. That MAR-2816, C-300-42140. Those were the bottles in the box. In the defendant's garage in the whole time. But then there was the bottle in the trash, in the victim's trash can, in Barnegat Light. What numbers were on that bottle? MAR-2816, C-300-42140. Guess he's trying to clean up. Well, forgot to take some things that clearly connected him to the residence. Now, the defense isn't saying he wasn't there. The cleanup. Still the state's burden to prove that he was. And I submit to you this, among other evidence, conclusively demonstrates that. What about that light bulb? That photo S-118. Where'd that come from? The plastic that was still in the fixture in Barnegat Light? and the bulb from the quilt stand home. There's the intact exterior bulb in S88 in evidence. I submit to you. That's from, as you're facing the house, the left light that was still intact. Seems to match up with the other one. Why would the defendant take that light? His friend, he killed, he wrapped him up in a blanket, and he intended him to remove him from that house. He didn't want to be seen. A trash at 2204 Central had his cork in it. Found a bottle in the defendant's garage. Do you really think, ladies and gentlemen, it makes sense that the victim drank all that alcohol himself? Do we even know if all that alcohol came from the same night? But no, what's important about that?